In lots of car reviews, there normally comes a point where the reviewer gets in the back or looks at the boot and says, it's good, but it's not as spacious as a Skoda Octavia. Because Skoda's family car has always been a supremely practical choice. And now here we are with a new fourth generation model, which is even more practical than before. But the differences aren't substantial. You get 30 more litres of boot space in the estate and an extra 10 litres in the hatch. And while the dimensions of the car are very slightly bigger than the previous Octavia, passenger space inside remains the same. That's definitely not a criticism though, because of course the Octavia had one of the most spacious interiors of any car in the family car class. So remember, this car's up against things like the Volkswagen Golf, which this car is very closely based on, and also the Ford Focus and other cars in that class. But it's always been the outstanding practical choice. Changes in the exterior styling are subtle too. The main change being the switch from the slightly controversial split headlight design to this, smoother version. The changes are more noticeable inside, with a two-spoke steering wheel and a general step up in quality throughout. You also now get a revamped digital driver display with nice, big, easy-to-read dials and a new infotainment system. But you can see again, we've got another manufacturer who, in upgrading their infotainment system, has tried to remove as many buttons as possible. So the result is something which is pretty much entirely touchscreen. And the screen itself is bright, responsive, nice graphics, looks really sharp. You've also got a digital voice assistant as well to help navigate through various different things. But it would just be a lot simpler if you had a physical dial or some buttons up here to help work it, especially when you're on the move. Because when you're driving, it is just a bit more distracting, isn't it? The climate control is also now within this touchscreen, but at least it's not hidden within a million different menus. It's nice and easy to find on the main screen along the bottom there. But you've got to still touch the screen, and it's just not as easy as having some dials down here, which would be much simpler. And also the volume control is this slidey bar thing. So if you want to turn it up, you slide your finger along the bottom of it, turn it down, you slide it down. But again, wouldn't you just want a dial? However, the look of the interior is definitely better than before. It looks really plush. The materials are really nice finish to them. You've got some Alcantara on the dashboard here, and this metal effect here and there is done really nicely. It's squidgy where it should be. And yes, there are some cheaper, scratchier feeling plastics down on the center console here, but generally it's got a really impressive feel in this interior, really good quality. Mechanically, things really aren't that different from the previous Octavia. So the basic elements are all pretty much the same, with some minor tweaks here and there. So for example, the suspension has the same setup as before, but they've tried to make it quieter and also slightly more comfortable.
The result is a very soft riding, comfortable car, which does occasionally feel a bit too soft, with a fair bit of bobbing up and down over undulating roads. But while it might not feel so tied down and controlled as some rivals, it's not enough to get irritating or uncomfortable.
But otherwise, it's the same dynamic package that we're used to from the Octavia. So you're not suddenly going to be raving about how well it drives, but it's really predictable, very stable, plenty of grip, nice responsive front end, body lean isn't ridiculous through corners, so you're not being thrown around all over the place. The steering's really nicely weighted too, and especially because this estate is quite a big car, but at low speeds, it's really light steering, just means that it's very easy to get it into tight parking spaces or anything. So that's all good, and it's really what we've come to expect from the Octavia. Although it certainly isn't as fun or as nice, enjoyable to drive as a Ford Focus. But as far as the engines go in the new Octavia, there's nothing too dramatic yet, because at launch, it's only going to have three engines available. You've got one 1.5 150 petrol engine, and you've got two 2-litre diesels. Now, the 1.5-litre petrol is an engine that we've tried in loads of other VW Group cars, and it's been really impressive in everything else, so you'd expect it to be pretty impressive in this Octavia. However, if you're going to be doing lots of miles and you're going to be filling this car up with loads of stuff, then you're probably going to want to look at the diesels. We're in the 2-litre 150 diesel, and it's really impressive. It's very strong on the motorway too, and it's generally just really impressive. Great fuel economy. The only thing that does slightly let it down is this automatic gearbox. Occasionally, which at very low speeds, and I mean when you come to a stop and when you go again, can be a bit slow. But when you're on the move, up and running, it's really nice and smooth. But there are quite a lot of other versions on the way. So there's a lower powered petrol, and there'll also be automatic versions, which are mild hybrid variants of those petrol engines. There's also going to be a full-on plug-in hybrid Octavia and a Octavia VRS, which is a performance-focused version. As well as that, you're going to have an Octavia Scout, which is the kind of jacked-up all-wheel drive version of the Octavia. So you'll have hatchback and estate and generally a very diverse choice for the Octavia. So it looks like it should be able to cater for pretty much anyone who wants something massive and practical.
So our first taste of the new Octavia shows that it takes all the good bits of the previous car and adds in a bit of polish to it. It's still very competitively priced too, so all of that means it remains among the very best family cars and estates that you can buy. To get a great deal on one and any of its rivals, go to whatcar.com and make sure you're subscribed, because we have new car reviews and reveals of new cars coming out every week.